let me put that damn player feedback back on, man. I'm never fucking with that shit again, man. That shit is crazy. Let me know when you're watching.
Plenty of speed and explosion is on display tonight. When you widen your lens a little bit, how do you think athleticism in this league has changed throughout the years?
Well, it has grown exponentially, Kevin. When you think about the advanced training methods, the knowledge around nutrition and rest and strength training, so beneficial to the athleticism that we see in the league. As a matter of fact, I question whether or not I would be able to play in this day and age based on the athleticism I had back in the 80s. I would have to really embrace that fitness and strength training to another level to play today.
I think you would have played in any era and been just fine.
Yeah, and look how it, when you're going down the court,
I'm not so sure though. These guys get after it. They're bigger, faster, and stronger than any players of any era to date.
Now, the starting group of the Milwaukee Bucks, Baker and Lopez are the bigs.
Yeah, that's why I'm like, yo, you're going to love this. This is the dream, bro. We need a playoff, bro. You know what I want you to do, bro?
The most improved player,
don't debut this view. Was a legit MVP contender. Until the season.
No doubt about it.
Until the season.
In the top seed.
I want this shit to be a surprise.
Won it, although James Harden was phenomenal last season. The league has been put on notice. This is a guy who wouldn't surprise me at all if he became an MVP at some point in his career.
Come on, I can see everybody. Boom, right there. And you see that view? That view is ill, man.
First points of the game.
The view is the
he's
shit.
Spotting his teammates, you know, Bledsoe is good.
No,
Dishes to Walker. Pass to Kid Gilchrist. Six on the shot clock. It's up a three. No good on the shot.
That's another miss. Already they've missed three out of four to start.
On the wing, Middleton can't get it to go. Hornets have gone just 1-4 to get this game started.
The way, the two with the ball. I want to see you play on this shit, man.
Kumbo. They get the rebound. Walker. And oh boy, a lot of contact there. Everybody gets the call.
I'm only going to play until like probably like the first quarter, man.
You know, I think opponents have learned it the hard way. I mean, Walker is not a guy.
I'm only going to play this shit until that.
He's an excellent
player in the first quarter.
You know, one of the things you see when you watch Kemba Walker,
do you got any strength left?
The evolution of his game. He, you know, came into the league as a guy with great athleticism, tremendous competitive spirit, but in today's game, guards have to be able to stretch the floor.
Now, here is Bledsoe. Stolen by Walker. Goes up and lays it.
I ain't gonna lie, man. The Hornets be a slick,
sneaky defender.
Right,
a lot of his skills result in instant offense.
And Kemba Walker is gonna pick up the foul.
Yeah, the nigga's.
That's his first foul.
He's looking lethal.
Walker, Clark, even he knew he had to improve from distance, and he put in the work.
Yeah, you know, the hard work is admirable, but it's not a guarantee, Kevin. It just gives you a chance to perhaps get better. There are a number of guys, Rajon Rondo, Tony Allen, for example, that tried to improve their shooting range but just never became consistent shooters from outside. Walker has, though, and it's put him into that upper echelon category of guards.
Wow. Bucks have gone 2-for-4 from the field so far. David Aldridge had a chance to catch up with head coach James Borrego. David, what do you have to say?
Well, Kevin, I asked him what the strategy was offensively, and he said, look, we want to avoid having to take so many outside shots. They want to exploit what he described as a mismatch inside. He said, we have the talent down low to make things very difficult for those guys. We're going to use it.
I ain't that bad.
Williams can't hit. The Bucks break through. Maker with the ball. Here's on to Kumbo. Off to a good start as he hits his first shot attempt.
That's why I got that.
Now here's Walker. This is it to Zeller. Over Lopez.
And he tries off the glass, but it's no good. Here's Maker. And a great assist by Bledsoe as that one goes in.
There's no question about it. Maker needs to get stronger, and he will. But baskets like this are still encouraging.
Williams a screen. Walker the pass to Kid Gilchrist.
Especially that when you're on the fast break. You're on the fast break.
That's and Maker sends it back. Bledsoe kicks to Maker. And two free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go.
Wait, the only thing that I feel about this
before the NBA, it was internet highlight reels that gave Thon Maker notoriety. His fluidity for a second.
Crazy.
Yet he's still figuring out how to get it done at
tied,
the NBA level.
Like this dumb.
And last year, Maker's minutes went up, but his shooting took a dip. Franchise were concerned.
No, not really, Kevin. I think he's shown that he's got NBA range and a nice stroke. An area where he needs.
Ooh! That was a crazy out of dunk, man. Yes, you about to see this shit.
How about the flash? Yeah,
I think that's my craziest dunk yet. Jesus Christ. What the fuck? Yo, you saw that shit? Oh my god! Oh my god, let's get it! Jesus Christ!
Just an insanely talented athlete who loves to punish that rim.
And there's the whistle. Illegal screen.
You can hear it. Some rumors.
Hold on. Look at Michael Gilchrist. Averaged 22 points a game.
22 points a game. 5 assists and 3 rebounds. And I think he's got to be pretty pleased with his output. And you know he's always looking to push himself.
Yeah, you know, really solid numbers across the board here, Greg. I mean, he contributes in a multitude of ways for this club.
Bridges is checked in for Kid Gilchrist. Offensive rebound, Bucks. Lopez passes to Bledsoe. Next down the three ball.
Bledsoe.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading.
Just great ball. I feel way more
and
comfortable.
Now the first time out call
way more
the
comfortable.
In the regular season.
With the damn shot thing, man. Like, I feel like they were trying to set us up, my nigga. I'm not going to hold you. These niggas are trying to set us up.
This speed, this talent. How nervous were you going back to that
These
time
niggas
are
trying to set us up, bro.
How nervous were you on opening night?
Very nervous. Really excited, but there were some butterflies that I had to work really hard.
Yeah, man, I think these niggas trying to set us up, bro. They saw us coming,
they
man.
They were all over the place, Kevin.
Yeah, I think I got another tip for you, too, man. I've been getting them tired, too, because I've been, you know, my hand been on the R2 button too much. So you got to try to minimize the R2 button and only try to, like, use it when you're about to break away on it.
Walker against Bledsoe. Dishes it to Antetokounmpo. And Antetokounmpo shaves it in.
Because, like I'll be, like, going down the court holding R2, so you can't control R2 like that.
Walker against Bledsoe. Pick by Zeller. Outside, Batum.
Yeah.
That one's off. He's now 1 for 2.
All the time in the world to get that one off.
And Snell. And that one hits back on.
And right play.
But it's red, right?
Generally, you knock those down.
Not much else you can do there. I mean, that's what you want. Too bad they weren't able to finish it off.
And they are very comfortable running their offense through Walker. And you can see Fly drops a sick dime right there. That pass was right on the money.
Bucks lead by 6. Bledsoe kicks to Lopez. Over Zeller. And the rebound goes to the Hornets.
Low percentage look on that one. Not sure what he was thinking.
Yo,
I agree with you. Not a good shot. Like, not good offense. They can get a much better look than that.
I feel like Beatrice, he don't really go tired like that either, man. He don't really, you know what I'm saying? I'm going to just work on a rotation. You know what I mean? Like, when I see 6 minutes coming
now,
on the tip.
Here's Bridges.
You know, certain people like Middleton on the
bench for you, switching for his first points of the game. Just two to shoot. Walker, nice teamwork to set up the pick play and make the space for the Jay.
And Walker, a really gifted guard, a guy you can trust to run the pick and roll to perfection.
Milwaukee, no good that time either.
Now, when it's time for 3 feet, and to put him back in.
Fires from 14, and all the
way. I ain't gonna lie, man. This nigga Kemba Walker.
Now, here's the 2 point Bucks lead. Out to the right wing. There's Maker. Second chance effort. It's gonna be 2 free throws. Drew contact on the shot.
And Brooke Lopez, a little bigger and more of an offensive player than his brother Rob. But they both turn.
Oh shit. I bet.
Monk. Kaminsky sets the pick for Monk. Milwaukee with the rebound. Maker's got his fourth rebound in this one. Outside, Antetokounmpo. Snell dishes to Antetokounmpo. Back to Snell. Over Monk. And it comes off the front of the rim.
I mean, look, no one guarding you. It's better to not pull up and try to leap.
Milwaukee in the lead. 2 seconds separating the shot clock and game. Snell, that's good.
You know, when you see Antetokounmpo make a pass like that, it tells you just how much he's matured and grown as a player and decision maker.
Here's Monk. The teardrop falls in. Monk's got seven.
Oh, such a field shot there. The floater.
Snell, no good on the buzzer beater. Still a close game as the first quarter comes to a close. Bucks lead by three. And we'll get the second quarter underway on the other side.
I just think it's part of the language of the game now, where it's more prevalent.
Bledsoe dishes to Henson. To the inside. And it's Lopez. A turn on the assist by Henson. That's now 8 points for...
situation this offseason. Atlanta in rebuild mode and the Milwaukee Bucks heading in the other direction. One of the best teams in the East. That's a good landing spot for Budenholzer.
Charlotte making some changes. Zeller is checked in for Biombo. Batum comes in for Jeremy Lamb. And it's Kemba Walker in for Tony Parker. The Bucks also with the sub. Malcolm Brogdon's checked in for Eric Bledsoe. And here they come. Here's Lopez. For his fourth field goal of the game on just 5 shots. And Budenholzer, well respected around the league. Talk about what he brings now, Clark, to the Milwaukee Bucks, his new team.
Yeah, I think he brings a continuity offensively, ball movement and spacing. It's a pretty good system defensively as well.
Zeller, a screen on Antetokounmpo. It's called for run. Kid Gilchrist, no luck. Bucks leading by 12. Here's Snell. He has 6. Down low, Kid Gilchrist with the steal. And now Batum pushing it up. No one back to stop him. And the shot goes in. Batum's got 7 points.
Boy, the quick feet and long strides of Batum, especially lethal in the open court.
Antetokounmpo against Kid Gilchrist. And here is Antetokounmpo. 10 points for him. 6 to shoot. Shoots over Kid Gilchrist, and he overshot that one, missing. Hornets trail by 10. Pick by Zeller. Launches a 3, and Nicholas Batum, good for 3. Batum's got 5 points now in the quarter.
The outside stroke of Batum, too nice. Knocks him down in bunches.
Michael Kidd-Gilchrist.
You might have heard the story about Giannis growing a couple of inches since he was drafted. How about the strength this kid is at? Under 200 pounds as a rookie. He's added a good 35 pounds of muscle through his dedication and weight.
Bridges is checked in for Charlotte. Snell, the pass to Lopez. Good. He's only missed 1 shot of his 6 taken on the floor.
They are just killing him on the interior.
Yeah, you can't say that with enough emphasis. I mean, the defenders are just not being aggressive enough down low. You got to play with some physicality in the paint.
Antetokounmpo dishes to Lopez. Oh, good with the triple. Hornets trail by 7. Inside. Here's Zeller, and good that time. Zeller's got 6 points.
And boy, has he come alive. Since the start of the second quarter, he has been on fire.
too impressed. Brogdon is a valuable role player who does a lot of things well.
Wow, what, did he have something in his eye on that shot?
Maybe. Dumbo, he's checked in for the Hornets. Tucker comes in for one. And there's the call on Malcolm Brogdon. That'll be his second foul of the game.
To the wing, right side. Monk kicks to Parker. To the right side. Shot clock at 6. Bridges passes to Biombo. A 3.
And he still scores in this quarter. Surprising after his great start.
No, he's been off so far, Kevin, but there's still time. I mean, he just needs to settle it down, idle it down a little bit, try to contribute as much as he can on the offense within himself.
Lopez, a screen on Bridges. Snell. And it's off the back rim. No good. Here's Sharp. They're on a 16-7 run. Lopez with the block. And so the ball goes out of bounds. Lopez touching. Man who's checked in for Sharp. Chris Middleton's checked in for the Bucks. Seconds left in the first half of basketball. They set the screen. 4 on the shot clock. From deep. They'll go get another chance. For Charlotte, they have yet to miss from the free throw line. They're 3 for 3. And the first one drops.
You know, Jeremy Lamb, what a nice stroke he has. I mean, says that in practice he makes about 350 shots a day. I wonder about these numbers sometimes, guys, quite honestly. But he does get some extra work in. Takes him about an hour and a half to get that many shots to go in.
8-second difference between the shot clock and the game. Goes back up. And there's the nice layup by Henson. Henson's got 6 points in the quarter.
And he has really come to life here after a slow start in that first quarter.
Now, here's Monk, defended by Middleton. Monk gets to land. Fires from the wing. And a pretty tightly contested. First half.
Thank you, Kevin.
All right, thank you, David. And folks, don't go away. After the break, we'll see you right back here for the start of...
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Ernie Johnson here with Shaq and Kenny. A competitive matchup for Milwaukee in the first quarter. At the end of the period, they held a 3-point lead. The second quarter was dead even in terms of their scoring output from both teams, and they still find themselves in a good position at the half. Kenny, your thoughts on the Bucks' first half? That about wrap.
Welcome back to Charlotte, the Duke Energy Center, the building in the foreground there. Here we go now, the start of the third quarter, welcoming you back in a closely contested first half so far. Kind of like what Nicholas Batum has done in this game.
Oh, well, they've done a good job of letting the game come to them, and really few forced shots here so far.
And, you know, Greg, I like how they've set the pace. There's a lot of time left in this one, so there's no rush. You don't have to go 70 miles an hour. Keep it at about 45.
Williams is down low with Zeller. Walker and Batum are the guard pair, and it's Kid Gilchrist at the 3. So that's who James Borrego starts the second half with. And that one, good.
And really, this is the area where Kid Gilchrist shines. I mean, he's very confident shooting from the interior.
Out to the right wing. Out of bounds.
Charlotte takes possession.
And a moment to see numbers for Nicholas Batum. How he performed last season. Last season, he averaged 11 points a game, 5 assists, and 4 rebounds. And some pretty good numbers, guys. He's certainly making a contribution.
Better than expected. He still has a ways to go. I like what I'm seeing right now.
Zeller dishes to Walker. That misses, had a chance to tie it there. Bucks leading by 3. Here's Antetokounmpo. It's rebounded by Charlotte. Zeller's got 4 rebounds in this game. Outside, Batum. Zeller setting the pick for Walker. Offensive rebound. Nice shot by Zeller. Zeller's got 8 points.
And defensively, this is the opposite of how you want to start the second half.
Yeah, just a real lack of aggressiveness there right now. I mean, can't give up these types of layups to begin the quarter, Greg. I mean, that's a no-no.
Hey, guys, the D has to show a little more fight on the interior than they did on that trip.
Walker against Bledsoe. Here's Williams. That falls. Nice feed that time from Walker. Walker's got his 4th assist in this one. For Milwaukee, they've gone 2 of 3 from the field to start the second half. Bledsoe passes to Maker. Over Williams. And the shot goes in. 10 points for Thon Maker.
Really, really good at recognizing the gaps and getting the ball to the rim.
Picked by Zeller. And Batum kicks to Walker. Pays it up off the glass. 10 points for him.
And, you know, Walker is really good at muscling his way through the defense. Tough to stop on the way up.
Passes it to Maker. Good. He's only missed 1 shot of his 6 taken on the floor.
And they're beginning to just flat out fall apart defensively right now, especially on the interior.
Yeah, and that's 4 straight field goals now, Greg, they've allowed from point blank range. Can't happen.
Here's Walker. Here's Zeller. And the dunk by Zeller.
And that's an example of willpower right there, guys. I mean, grabbing the offensive rebound and then going back up strong.
And, G.A., in a close game like this where every possession is critical, that could prove to be a very big one.
Oh, it sure could, Kevin. I mean, he salvaged 2 big points for them off that miss.
Okay, well, let's check in with David Aldridge, who's reporting from the sideline.
Well, it is the era of positionless basketball, but what exactly did this get here? Well, new defensive rules at the turn of the century encouraged face-up scoring, motion-based offense, and guard play over isolation and post-ups. As a result, offensive rules have become more interchangeable.
It has become a positionless game now, David. Thank you very much. And so he draws the foul on the shot, a trip to the line to shoot 2. Clark, a favorite topic of yours, great rebounders, glass eaters, as you call them. Who's the best at creating those important second chance opportunities for his team?
Well, a couple of guys stand out for me in that regard. Kevin, DeAndre Jordan is terrific in his canter. Probably, he might be the best offensive rebounder in the league in his canter. And he goes and gets it in his area, out of his area, through guys, over them. Man, he's a terrific offensive rebounder. And I throw on Anthony Davis in there, too. I think he does a great job on the defensive glass and gets his share of offensive boards as well.
Benson with the screen. A shot by Middleton. Wide open. 3-pointers off the mark. Charlotte leading by 3. Outside, Kid Gilchrist. That misses off the back.
I guess even he has to miss one of those once in a while.
Now against Walker. Great captured by Walker. Now, Kid Gilchrist. And it goes down 2 points. Kid Gilchrist has got 6.
This is Kid Gilchrist at his best. An exceptional athlete who's dangerous on the drive.
Out of bounds. Charlotte takes possession. You know, these are the guys you need to be aware of. If you don't want your pocket hit,
Here are last season's steals leaders. Third is Eric Bledsoe.
He showed such tremendous defensive instincts. Trust me, nobody wanted him guarding them last year.
High post shot. And Henson pulls it down. Henson's got six rebounds now in the game. Here's Antetokounmpo. Good on the shot. And with that, the Charlotte lead is cut to just 3 points on the basket from Henson.
Henson very skilled down low and almost 7 feet tall. The defense cannot allow him to get deep position.
Rebound out is Antetokounmpo. The Bucks have gone 5-9 on field goal attempts since halftime. Middleton, quick shot there and it's off target.
And he has lost all confidence out there. Still not a single field goal made in the game.
Not loose. Jed Gilchrist with it. And it's Henson picking him up. He gets it in there. Zoller's got the lead up to 5 now for Charlotte.
You know, Michael Kidd Gilchrist getting better at recognizing when his teammates are open. He continues to improve. He's more valuable as a teammate.
Maker misses. Charlotte has gone 0-2 from deep to start things here in the second half. Walker goes in. And it's Eric Bledsoe with the rebound. Bucks trail by 5. Kicks to Antetokounmpo. A pass to Maker. Wants to get it to Antetokounmpo and does. Over Kidd Gilchrist. Down it goes. Nice one there from Antetokounmpo. Antetokounmpo's. Now tonight. 7 lead changes now and we're just in the third quarter.
Yeah, frustrating for a coach, but it's great to watch as a fan.
Monk, no one around him, gets the three-pointer to fall. Monk's got 10 points. And at 6'11", some people had Henson listed as a power forward.
Well, you know, in today's game, he's almost exclusively a center. His mobility helps. He's a shot blocker who's comfortable scoring around the basket. 5 spot is where he's most effective, I think.
5 on the clock. Shoots inside. Whistle on the play. Bucket's good. He'll go to the line.
Just no resistance on the inside. That's their 5th consecutive make in the paint.
And Greg, those looks they're allowing are almost automatic.
And Chris Middleton, 2 seasons ago, tore his hamstring completely off the bone. I mean, he's come back and hasn't missed a beat. One of the most well-rounded players you see.
And that one drops.
And they haven't been able to turn it into a big lead, but their rebound advantage is starting to add up.
Yeah, still close, but with their tough play on the boards, we're certainly seeing the effort.
With the fadeaway, the Hornets pull it in. Biombo's got 4 rebounds now tonight. And
Chris Middleton with maybe Greg his best season yet in 2017-18.
It just seems like he gets better every year. Former second round kid, now all-star caliber. He's worked extremely hard, stayed in the lab, and now we're seeing the results.
And the Bucks miss again.
Tell you what, he's going to buy himself a ticket to the bench if he keeps shooting it like that. He has been putrid here this quarter.
There's a screen. Here's Lamb. And it's wide right. It's off the rim.
Well executed. Great rhythm. You've got to finish that.
I agree with you there, partner, because that screen really freed him up nicely, and that's a shot. If you're a pro, you need to make that one.
Let's it go from deep. Rebounded by Maker. Maker's got rebound number 5 here tonight. Snell dishes to Middleton. A quick look, no good that time.
Yeah, that's just poor decision making, and he's got to be better in those situations.
Greg, I just think he was in a hurry. He flat out rushed it. I mean, I don't know what he was thinking there. He actually was in a brain neutral position.
Pretty much all of their buckets coming from inside the paint now.
Charlotte trailing. Pass to Lamb. For Lamb. Good on the second free throw.
And what a career it's been for Tony Parker. 4 titles to his name, a Finals MVP, 6-time All-Star. I mean, the accolades go on and on for what is truly one of the most impressive resumes you'll see in the NBA.
Shots good by Middleton.
And he's showing signs now of life after going scoreless through the half.
Hornets trail by 5. With and some statue guys, the scoring breakdown for the Bucks.
Well, their basket has been picturesque, a thing of beauty in both halves. More than a few of their baskets have come off assists.
And also, how about the points they've got in transition or on the fast break tonight? That's been a huge factor as well.
And the Bucks may get a change here. Watkins checked in. Good screen. Lopez a screen. Here's Middleton, and he gets the shot to fall after coming off the pick. Middleton's got 10 points.
Yeah, but he's been flat out phenomenal, superb, simulating this quarter. He's carving him up, knocking down everything.
Now 8 seconds separating the 2 clocks. Pass to Monk. A 3. And the rebound goes to Lopez. Lopez has got double-digit rebounds now in the game. Middleton for 3. The Hornets pull it in. From deep. No good on their last second attempt here. And so it's Milwaukee with their lead standing at 6 points here at the end of the quarter. And now we have a moment to reveal our State Farm assist of the game.
And definitely deserving of the prize tonight. How about the read he made here? Looking like a point guard, putting the pass right on the money.
Terrific versatility coming from a big man. Not something that the majority of big guys possess.
Welcome back.
as we get rolling once more. The fourth quarter right ahead in what's been a very well-contested game. On the floor for Milwaukee, starting the fourth quarter. Brogdon and Middleton pair up at the one and the two. Maker and Lopez are the bigs. And Schnell at the small forward position. Passes to Biombo. Now here's Parker. They set the pick. He kicks it to Monk. Over Lopez. That one wide left. Bucks leading by six. Middleton the pass to Lopez. Here's Brogdon. Plays it up and banks it in. Brogdon's got the first basket as we get going in the fourth for the Bucks. Charlotte shooting the ball at 42%. Parker outside. Just over a minute played here in the fourth. He used that pick to perfection. And that's 13 points for Malik Monk.
And he's finally getting the feel from beyond. His second three of the half right there.
It's good from long range.
You know, he was a non-factor in that first half, but now he's making up for lost time.
Charlotte calls timeout.
Malcolm Brogdon, the 36th pick in the 2016 draft, went on to win Rookie of the Year. I mean, that's the second time a player not taken in the first round received that award. The first time was back in 1957. Kevin, you probably know who that is because you've been called on this game.
No, I'm not that old, Clark. You sure you're not thinking of a game maybe you called back in the day? Catching up on the changes for Charlotte. Zeller's checked in for Biombo. Batum comes in for Monk. And Walker subbed in for Tony Parker. The Bucks also changing it up. John Henson comes in for Brook Lopez. And it's Ilyasova in for Maker. He gets a chance now to catch up with the fourth member of our crew, Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Thanks, Kevin. James Borrego had some words for his team over the break. He does not like the high foul movement in this game. He told them, you've got to stop fighting on the shot fake. For steals. That's giving them easy points at the line. We'll see how they respond.
Thanks so much, David. Schnell, no good. How do you think about Brogdon slipping into the second round? Clark, what caused so many teams to pass on?
Well, you know, in this day and age, Kevin, younger is deemed to be better, and if you've happened to be in college 4 or 5 years, you're looked at a little differently. He spent 5 years at the gym. To his credit, he got his bachelor's degree and a master's in public policy, so he's got great character and perseverance.
And he knocks down the first one.
I tell you, Bridges, you see the athleticism, the improving skill set, and the instincts are coming along.
Marvin Williams has checked in for Frank Kaminsky. Brogdon against Walker. Brogdon picks the spell. Ilyasova in the post. No good there. Now Charlotte takes it the other way. Bridges dishes to Walker. And Henson sends it back.
Well, I like seeing Henson make good use of that real reach of his to deny shots.
And again, the Bucks miss. Hornets trail by three. Here's Batum to the left side wing. Nice pass in here by Charlotte. And Batum throws it down.
What an impressive game for Batum. I mean, in attack mode every time he touches the ball.
Henson with the screen. Locked in the pass to Snell. Williams with the steal. Now, here's Bridges. He's covered closely.
I'm a fan of anybody who defends that way. I mean, they weren't about to open the door and just allow him to cruise in for a layup.
Knocks down the three ball. Brogdon's got 5 points now in the quarter.
Brogdon extremely comfortable taking these jump shots because he knows he has the green light.
Zeller setting the pick for Walker. High arcing shot. It's blocked. Valentine, Hornets retain possession. Charlotte making a switch. Kid Gilchrist has checked in. Six to shoot.
Dishes to Kid Gilchrist. Zeller setting the pick for Kid Gilchrist. Shot off the screen, and it's off the back rim. No good. Bucks leading by five. Here's Antetokounmpo. 2 points. That one goes. Antetokounmpo's got 18 points just in the second half.
And he's starting to show that killer instinct this quarter, looking to extend the lead.
A baseline chain. Shot's good by Walker.
The question is, can they ride him and get
Duncan. Kicks to Antetokounmpo. Shoots over Kid Gilchrist. And again, Giannis Antetokounmpo. Antetokounmpo's got 32 points in the game. Out to the right wing. Shoots from the baseline. Walker's shot is off. Milwaukee's gone 2 of 5 on three-point shots since the end of the third quarter. Pass to Brogdon. Ilyasova, a screen on Walker. They get it back. DiVincenzo. Bullseye! And now a 9-point Bucks lead.
Oof, that is a tough shot.
Charlotte has gotten 3 of their 6 three-pointers to fall here in the fourth. And here's the 2. Top Walker. Shot clock at 6. Buries the long range jumper. Walker's got 29 in the game.
And really, the scoring this quarter has been just off the charts, doing all he can to bring him back.
Now a timeout called by Milwaukee. And the Charlotte Hornets wanted to become more efficient shooting the 3-ball last year, and they certainly did.
Part of the efficiency was because they took fewer threes and better quality threes as well. Also, some of their younger guys are just becoming more consistent shooters from that range.
Bucks leading by 6. From the wing. Wow, way off on that one. Charlotte has gone 4-7 with the long ball here in the fourth quarter. The 2 passes to Walker. Batum against Middleton. And Batum kicks to Kid Gilchrist. For Antetokounmpo. Kid Gilchrist, no luck. The Bucks shooting has been great, up over 50%. In fact, 52%. Lopez outside. Pass to Maker. Now Plutso. Just 5 on the clock. Middleton on the wing. Let's it go from deep. Seller grabs the board. Hornets trail by 6. Walker goes in. Out of bounds. Milwaukee takes possession. So it's the Bucks now. They've held a 12-point lead early. Bledsoe passes to Maker. Good, and Bledsoe gets the assist. Bledsoe's got his 8th assist here tonight.
Feeling it. No doubt about it. He's definitely feeling it right now. Shooting a terrific percentage.
Love whenever he gets up to swat shots back.
1:49 left to play here in the fourth. Here's Walker. Rebound in Milwaukee. Maker's got 7 rebounds in the game. Antetokounmpo gets to Middleton. Coming into this game, it was indeed another big game tonight for Giannis Antetokounmpo.
And, you know, he was really important today. Integral, taking and making shots time and time again.
Charlotte calls timeout. They trail by 10. 24 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Seconds left to play in the final quarter. Lamb passes to Biombo. Nice pass in here by Charlotte. They get it again. Bridges, no one around him. Buries it from three-point range.
Capable of scorching you from the perimeter when Bridges has a great look. He takes advantage.
Good work there as it goes. And the Bucks lead by 9.
And that's a killer instinct on display as they try to put this one on ice.
This is what's needed at this point in the game, Greg. The great team know how to close it out.
Six seconds left in the fourth quarter of this one. Good on the three-point shot.
Jeremy Lamb moves so well with or without the ball, and I like his creativity in using the screens like this.
Here's on to Jakubo. So it's Milwaukee picking up the win. A truly gutsy performance away from home.
You know, it really was. And Kevin, when this one was hanging in the balance late, they showed just what a tough-minded group they can be.
And a chance now to send it over to David Aldridge, standing by courtside. David.
Thanks, Kevin. Here with Eric Bledsoe. Eric, a strong performance tonight. What's been the difference?
We're getting out of transition, you know, trying to get defense to stop. And everybody's just playing their game.
And it showed tonight, Eric. Thanks very much. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. And that'll wrap it up, folks. For Greg Anthony, Clark Kellogg, and Dick.